Welcome to The Spread, JLN's weekly recap of options, markets, and other financial miscellany, brought to you by MIAX. I'm Spencer. Here we go. What a good options industry conference in Florida. Many thanks to MIAX as the host exchange and all the hard work from those with the OCC and OIC who helped make the sausage. Next year, the industry will congregate in Puerto Rico, and note, there is a casino on the premises of the resort where SIBO will be the host exchange of the conference. If any potential attendee has a birthday between April 22nd and 24th, be sure to collect your $10 free play at the tables. As for this conference, what was grinding people's gears? Well, there's a lot to be happy about in this industry. So many things that are commonly griped about, there's been some progress made on correcting bank capital rules so risk is properly measured, give up protocol, strike delistings, all some progress. Now, things that won't be going away, concerns about the general health and concentration of liquidity providers and market fragmentation complaints. But that's just the way it is. Speaking of fragmentation, NYSE is sitting on exchange medallions it likely won't use, and NASDAQ could free up a medallion. Or one of the other exchanges could launch another outfit. I'd like to see somebody make odds on which of the above happens next. And thinking of odds, I can't help but think of the Derby. Man, people say maximum security, but more like maximum disappointment for quite a few bettors. Anyways, given that it was MIAX sponsoring the OIC this year and MIAX is home to the Spikes Index options offering, it was no surprise this was a topic of conversation. And it was at the conference that MIAX announced that they had an arrangement in place to list Spikes futures on the Minneapolis Grain Exchange. Now, there is much that needs to happen here. MGEX has its products available on CME's Globex, so it's nice for MIAX that SPIAX could have that spotlight. But the clearing arrangement might not be optimal, and there are some huge regulatory hurdles that need to be overcome for this to happen. Now, I'll be going into those weeds in the near future, but I need to do some poking through old SEC joint orders in order to really get into that minutia. As it stands, MIAX is looking at Q3 to launch that product. Meanwhile, SIBO beat analyst estimates for first quarter profits last week, as did CME Group. Obviously, volumes are lagging after a banner 2018. This all comes after a report that showed that the world's largest exchanges average 60% profit margins. Now, one regulatory thing. I had to shake my head when I saw the news about the Anadarko insider trading with options. Yet another violation of Matt Levine's insider trading rules, which firmly state that large in size, out-of-the-money options trading and equities with negligible options volumes before major news announcements is just a big, obvious no-no. Well, and then there's today's action. Monday. What a fun one. Open up more than 1.5% down, depending on your market measure of choice, and finish the day down a handful of tenths, percentage-wise. The tweeter-in-chief has really entrenched social media risk as a real thing. Now, again, thank you to all of the attendees and gracious hosts down in Florida. I am entirely appreciative of the experiences and connection that I make there. This industry is full of some truly remarkable people. Till next time.